This is the propane adapter off my Kohler generator. And this part threads into the bottom. And I never could figure out when I was fiddling around with this how it would work with a demand regulator, because the propane coming into the carburetor needs to be up where the venturi is. Well, yesterday I was online and I found somebody had a photograph of their part like this, and it actually has this extra chunk on it. And so looking at this really closely, it looks as though somebody has cut this off with a hacksaw at some time in the past, for who knows why. But it's supposed to look like this. So this part is down here, and then it has this couple inches of tube that would go up to around the venturi area of the carburetor. So I'm going to try to make one of these out of a chunk of brass that I've got here. I'm going to manufacture it this direction, so there's a cone out here. It's got a hole down the center, a 3/8 inch hole, and this widens out to almost a 1/2 inch here. And so I'll do the threads last. Most of these dimensions I got off of the photograph. I just had it on my computer and I measured. So I think 3 3/8 is the total length. I got that off of the forum that I found this picture on. 3 3/8 here, and a 3/8 hole down the center, 3/8 hole through here. And so a lot of these other dimensions I got from just scaling it down. And the lathe I'm using is a Sheldon 11 inch from like 1940 vintage. That's better. That's $4.99, and the hole in here is about a half inch. So I think by the time I polish that up, I'm gonna call it good. So I'm going to run this diameter 1.76 down to here, then step up to around a half inch, a little bit more for this next section. I've got this roughed out all the way down the shoulders where the threads are going to start and go this direction. So this is a 5/8 diameter. This fits into the bore of the mixer. So I'm going to now bore the hole. Okay, how far do I have to go? 176 plus about a half, so 2 1/4 inches in. A tapered section here. That's about 3/4 inch back. It's where it starts and just tapers down to next to nothing up here at the end. So I'll start 3/4 back and I'm going to set my compound up. I don't know what the angle is, but I'll just set a slight angle and start chewing away at it. Got my threading tool set up here, pretty much perpendicular with the work. So this is a 5/8 18 thread, and I've got the lever set up to do an 18 threads per inch, so we'll put this into back gear. I'm not going to thread it very quickly because I'm so close to the headstock. There we go. the same. That is, look at that. And we have to cut 1 inch worth of threads, so just going to go all the way up to the end there. Tight still. Go a couple more passes. Perfect. Okay, part it off next and cut the end slot and just finish it up a little bit here and there and drill this cross hole through here, right through this area. Well, got the hole drilled, cut a slot in the end with a hacksaw. So let's put this all together and see how well everything fits. That looks like it might work.